Friends, so in last lecture we have studied about the importance of soil, right? We have seen how the different living things they live in soil, how they make soil as their home. We have seen some microorganisms which live in soil. We have also seen how the soil is useful for us to the living world, right? How the soil is used in agriculture, for storing the underwater, right? Storage of water is done in soil. Then we also discussed about the agriculture, how the soil is important for growing plants. We have seen how the different articles, different toys and bricks, houses are made from soil, right? So in the earlier lecture, we have discussed all the things within the soil, right? The importance of soil. Now in today's class, we will learn some application of soil. Okay, students? So now what happens to the soil when it rains heavily or winds blow strongly? The soil is swept away. The soil is swept away. This washing or blowing away of the top layer of the soil due to strong winds and rain is called soil erosion. Now students, you're going to mark this full line. Washing or blowing away the top layer of the soil due to winds and rain is called soil erosion. So what is soil erosion? If you can see the picture, the first picture in your book, if you see this picture of the soil erosion, what is soil erosion? What happens when it rains heavily, when it is raining heavily, or there is a lot of wind, blowing wind. So क्या होता है, soil का जो ऊपर का layer होता है वो blow हो जाता है, it's swiped away, right? It blows away with the pressure of air, with the wind, or it flows away with the rain water. So फिर इससे क्या होता है, soil पूरी तरह से बह जाता है. That is called as soil erosion. This is called as soil erosion. What is soil erosion? Washing and blowing of soil because of wind and rain. Now some human activities like cutting of trees, farming, grazing of animals and so on also result in soil erosion. So kuch human activities hamari hoti hai, jaise we cut down the trees or we take animals for grazing, right? ग्रास खाने के लिए हम जब एनिमल्स को बाहर ले जाते हैं, दैट ग्रेजिंग ऑफ एनिमल्स एंड मेनी अदर फार्मिंग एक्टिविटीज़ कुछ होते हैं, उससे भी सॉइल इरोजन होता है व्हेन यू कट डाउन. सो वी विल डिस्कस दिस वन बाय वन. नाउ हाउ कैन वी प्रिवेंट सॉइल इरोजन? द वेरी फर्स्ट पॉइंट विच दे हैव गिवन यू इज द रूट्स ऑफ प्लांट्स होल्ड अ सॉइल टाइटली टुगेदर. वॉट डज द रूट्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स डू? दे होल्ड द सॉइल टाइटली टुगेदर. सो जितने भी प्लांट्स होते हैं उनके रूट्स जो अंडरग्राउंड होते हैं, राइट, रूट्स आर अंडरग्राउंड. सो व्हाट दे डू? दे होल्ड द सॉइल, सॉइल को पकड़ के रखते हैं, वो बहुत मजबूती के साथ सॉइल को वो पकड़ के रखते हैं. सो दे होल्ड द सॉइल वेरी टाइटली. सो बाय प्लांटिंग मोर एंड मोर प्लांट्स वी कैन रिड्यूस सॉइल इरोजन. ग्रास कैन ऑल्सो बी ग्रोन टू होल्ड द सॉइल. सो ये जितने भी रूट्स होते हैं सॉइल के अंदर वो सॉइल को पकड़ के रखते हैं. तो चाहे फिर बारिश, जितनी भी बारिश हो या विंड ब्लो होता है, जब हेवी विंड्स आते हैं उस समय सॉइल को पकड़ के रखने का काम रूट्स करते हैं. सो इट इज़ ऑलवेज बीन टोल्ड दैट वी शुड प्लांट मोर एंड मोर ट्रीज बिकॉज इट हैज़ मैनी मैनी गुड थिंग्स, राइट. सो उसी तरह से अगर आप प्लांट्स को ग्रो करोगे, बहुत ज़्यादा प्लांट्स, मोर एंड मोर प्लांट्स ग्रो करोगे, तो वो रूट्स सॉइल को मजबूती के साथ पकड़ के रखेंगे एंड इट विल प्रिवेंट soil erosion. Second one they have given you is burns can be built across the farms to prevent rain water from washing away the soil. So students, agar aap ye picture mein dekh rahe ho, second picture mein, what happens when it rains heavily, when it is raining heavily, so jitna bhi land portion hota hai, the ground, the farm land, it gets into the water, puri tarah se wo pani mein डूब जाता है, राइट. इट गेट्स द वाटर इज स्प्रेड एवरीवेयर इन द फार्म. सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट व्हेन दैट वाटर फ्लोज इट टेक्स सॉइल विथ इट ऑल्सो. तो वो पूरी सॉइल भी अपने साथ वो वॉश आउट करता है. बट इफ यू बिल्ड बंड्स, बंड्स यानी अगर आप यहाँ पे देखोगे ये जो बंड्स बनाए होते हैं मिट्टी के बंड्स, कि वो पानी को वहाँ पे स्टॉप करके रखता है. एंड देन दैट वाटर इज एब्जॉर्ब्ड बाय द सॉइल, वो पानी फिर एब्जॉर्ब हो जाता है. सो वहाँ पे अगर आप वाटर को ऐसे बंड्स बना के स्टोर करोगे, स्टॉप कर दोगे फ्लो होने से, तो मिट्टी का इरोजन होना, लाइक सॉइल इरोजन होना वापस प्रिवेंट होता है, राइट. सो बंड्स कैन बी बिल्ड अक्रॉस द फार्म्स टू प्रिवेंट रेन वाटर फ्रॉम वॉशिंग अवे द सॉइल, राइट. सो नाउ हियर, डंपिंग ऑफ वेस्ट अफेक्ट्स द क्वालिटी ऑफ सॉइल. Using chemicals to grow crops also affects the quality of the soil. The addition of harmful waste to the soil is called soil pollution. You are going to mark this line. The addition of harmful waste to the soil is called soil pollution. So students, if you see, when people are doing agriculture, farming, they use many chemicals and pesticides, right, on the crops so that their crops should grow good. Right? So for that the purpose, when they use these chemicals and the pesticides to clean the germs or to clean the insects on plants and crops, तो ये जो chemicals होते हैं वो मिट्टी में mix हो जाते हैं, they get mixed into the soil, and because of this the fertility of the soil is reduced, right? So this is called the soil pollution. Because of this the soil has been polluted. Including this, there are few waste material which you dump in the soil. कुछ लोग dump कर देते हैं soil में waste material. Even that degrades the quality of soil. Burning of waste into the soil, or dumping the waste into the soil, or using chemicals, different types of chemicals for farming, जो मिट्टी में mix हो जाते हैं. So because of this, the fertility of the soil or the quality of the soil has been reduced, and this is called as the soil pollution. It makes the soil unfit for growing plants, right? So it is unfit. It is not good for growing crops. It can have various ill effects on plants, animals and human beings too. Now, how can you prevent soil pollution? They have given here some techniques by which we can prevent the soil pollution. The first one is, we should use products which can be broken down easily by the microbes in the soil. For example, paper breaks down easily in the soil, but plastic doesn't, which we have discussed in the earlier lesson, right? So we should not use plastic, because plastic doesn't get mixed in soil as easy. In fact, it doesn't get mixed with the soil. So it is very harmful for our environment. So we should use such things which are easily decay, or which gets broken down easily in the soil, which, yes. And the second thing is, use of harmful chemicals in farming activities should be avoided. So as we discussed, we should not use the chemicals in the farming activities. Third, they have given you, before throwing the waste from industries and houses, it should be treated to prevent soil pollution. So what happens when you let down all the waste from the industries or from the houses directly in the soil? It will spoil the soil, it will pollute the soil, right? It will make the soil unfit, unfertile. So what we should do, we should treat those waste first. It should be seen that no harmful things are been added there, so that we should prevent the soil pollution, right? So now students, they have asked you, can you think of some other measures to prevent soil pollution? So now you should think that, can you do something to prevent soil pollution, or what can we do to prevent soil pollution? Yes, so you should think for this. Now, there is one amazing fact which they have given you here. A small spoonful of soil may contain 5,000 to 7,000 types of bacteria. So students, if you take one spoonful of soil, if you take one spoon of soil, it has almost 5,000 to 700 bacteria present in it. So can you imagine how much? Right, so too many. In higher order thinking skills, they have given you, have you ever observed the sand on seashores or riverbeds? How is it different from the soil we find in farms and fields? So they have given you the pictures here of sand and soil. Okay, so sand is found mostly near the river sides or on the sea beaches, beach and soil, water areas. Whatever you get, बिसाइड रिवर्स वाटर एरियाज, ओके, पानी के आसपास जो सॉइल आपको मिलता है दैट इज मोस्टली सैंड. सो यू गेट सैंड नियर वाटर वाटर बॉडीज एरिया, राइट? एंड सॉइल इज फॉर्म्ड इन लैंड, ओपन लैंड्स और इन फार्म्स. सो डोंट यू थिंक दे आर बोथ आर डिफरेंट? सैंड इज डिफरेंट, सॉइल इज डिफरेंट, राइट? सो यू विल थिंक फॉर दिस मोर एंड ट्राई टू फाइंड आउट द डिफरेंस बिटवीन सैंड एंड सॉइल. सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड द लेसन इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ सॉइल. And in the next class, we will complete the workbook question answers. Thank you.